Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Danae, and today I'm bringing you along on my Halloween home tour for this year. If you didn't catch last year's, I will be sure to leave a link here for you, but I just love Halloween. It is one of my favorite holidays. Even growing up, it was always just such a fun experience for us. My mom always decorated for Halloween. Trick-or-treating was a big deal for us. We did costume contests, and that love for the holiday has really just carried on throughout my life into my adulthood. And even now as a mom, my husband shares in the excitement with me. Our 3-year-old son is really getting into it this year, and I just think it's so awesome. So I am gonna be taking you around our home, showing you where I decorated, how I've decorated and put things together, and where things have come from. A lot of the stuff that I get to decorate for Halloween actually comes from the Dollar Tree and really affordable places like Walmart, Hobby Lobby, Home Goods, places like that. And I also do a lot of DIY stuff for my Halloween decor. And if you didn't catch those videos, I will be sure to link those for you as well. But I just really want to show you that you don't have to spend a lot of money to make the holidays fun and festive. You can be creative and think outside of the box, or just recreate some of these things that I'm going to be showing you today, just to bring a little enjoyment into your home for this season. Hopefully the lighting is gonna cooperate with me today, but walking into our front door, you are essentially walking into our living room and front entryway, and hanging on our front door is this baddie wreath. This is a DIY project that I made this year. Like I said, I will link to those videos down below. This one was super easy, and it is definitely one of my favorites. What I love about it is, first of all, I got a steal on this wreath and got it for less than $12. And I share with you in the video how I did that. And I also love that these bats are removable. So I can use this year after year, different holidays, different seasons, change out the bats. I can do something Christmassy and fun with it. I can put floral or greenery on it. And I just love that it's gonna be interchangeable and something that I can bring into the home year after year. On the opposite side of the door when you walk in, again, I apologize for this lighting. The sun is kind of going in and out, and it's kind of messing with my lighting here. But another DIY project that is in the same video as that baddie wreath. These plaques are definitely one of my favorites. I feel like I'm gonna say that a lot, guys. I'm so sorry. But these plaques are so fun, and they were super easy to put together. I love this one. It's just fun, spidery looking one, and then the skeleton hand. I originally intended for the skeleton hand to actually be a key holder, which it can be, but the keys that I have are a little too heavy for it, and I decided to take them down because I was really worried that they were gonna fall and break. So I need to get some lighter, smaller skeleton keys to hang on there. So for now, I'm just leaving them empty-handed, no pun intended. You can also hang your regular keys there too. Then on the opposite side of the wall is my entryway table, and I just have some of this black mesh tablecloth from Hobby Lobby draped on top of it. And this mirror, again, is a DIY project that I've recently shared. Super easy, very affordable, just repurposing things that I already had on hand. And then over here, I have this metal, I guess it's kind of a flower holder. I don't really know what you would call it, but anyways, it came from the Hearth and Home. I always say it wrong. The Magnolia line from Target. I don't remember what it's called. Forgive me, Joanna Gaines. This is from the Hearth and Hand. No. Anyways, it's from Target. And my mom got it for me. I love it. I think it's beautiful. I think that they still have it. I don't know. I will try to link for it and find it for you if I can. But it also has this little holder in here. If you do want to put some floral pieces in here, it can also come out if you want to use it for something else. I used it for these branches that I literally picked from our front yard last year and spray painted them black, and then I added these fun little Dollar Tree ravens onto them. They just have these little wire picks on the bottom of their feet, and they attach really well to things like this or like a wreath or something like that. Also, I'm gonna apologize if you keep hearing noise in the background or I keep getting interrupted because my little guy is here with me, and of course he is needing all of the things while I'm filming this video. But moving on, I have these fun little pumpkins. I believe this one came from the Target Dollar Spot last year, and this one, this fun sequins sparkly one, it came from Home Goods or Target. I don't remember where. I don't remember where that one came from. One of those places. This one for sure is from Home Goods, and then that little candle pillar holder is also from Home Goods, and then of course this is a Dollar Tree skull. They light up. They're really fun. My son loves them. And then I have my one of my all-time favorite fall candles here, Leaves from Bath & Body Works. I feel like this is a cult classic for so many people. And then this little tea light holder came from Home Goods as well. And then I have another Dollar Tree skull. These are the keys that I was referring to. They're beautiful. We got them in Savannah years ago. And I love them, but they are super duper heavy, and I just am a little too worried about them hanging from that skeleton hand. And then this little guy, I think is so cute. He came from the Dollar Tree last year. And then of course, if you didn't catch it, which I don't know how you could have missed it, all of my little bat friends hanging on the wall. I have used these for so many years. I can't even tell you how long I've had these things. I have added to my collection over the years. They are literally just little black cardstock bats that I have cut out on my own, and as I need more each year, I add to it. But I think that I found this idea. You did help mommy. Yeah. I think I found this idea years ago, like in a Better Homes and Gardens magazine, I want to say, and just loved the idea. I used it in our last house, and they just go with me wherever I go. And then the only other place that I decorated in the living room this year is our fireplace. And I have these beautiful built-ins on both sides of the fireplace, but I just don't put a whole lot in them for the holidays. I just kind of keep them as they are. I don't want it to look too cluttered with holiday stuff, if that makes sense. But this is Walter. He is our little English bulldog. My husband loves English bulldog. We do not have him because we are Georgia fans. Let's just get that clear right now. Even though we live in Athens, we are not dog fans. But this is Walter, and he is modeling this fun, cute little witch's hat that I got at Hobby Lobby. It's just like a little felt hat, and it's just kind of fun to put on him. And then this is Fast Eddie. He has been with our family for...
And that is a skeleton.
That's a skeleton. He's been with our family for 9-ish years or so. And he died because he was a candy stealer.
And skeleton.
Yeah. The tombstone actually came from the Dollar Tree. They still have them this year. I know that because I had to go get a new one because Gunner tore mine apart last year. And then up here is just some spider webbing that we got from Oriental Trading Company. The Oriental Trading Company webbing is really great because it's super long and it has the holes built into them already. Where the other ones from like Dollar Tree, Walmart, places like that, you have to actually put the holes into them. And then the skulls up here, honestly guys, I don't remember where these came from. Maybe Target? But I have one on each side of the TV. And the Happy Haunting sign was a DIY from last year. Super easy, but really cute. I love, love that sign. Moving into the kitchen, I kind of struggled this year with this little corner that we have here, but I just kind of went with like a witch's theme here in the kitchen. Kind of like her little area where she can brew up like some potions and spells and things like that. So in this little corner, I have my fun little skeleton hanging. He came from the Dollar Tree. These remind me of the Dementors from Harry Potter. I just think that they're really fun and add a fun little touch. And then down here, I have my Nora Fleming candy dish with my little Halloween hand, which I think is so cute, and some candy corn. If you guys have not ever tried this mix, seriously, even if you're not a candy corn fan, this sweet and salty combination is so, so good. It tastes like a payday bar if you've ever had one. It is delicious. But anyways, moving on. This cake tray is actually from Hobby Lobby. And then I have this DIY sign from the Dollar Tree. I just used a black Halloween tray and then attached this Black Hats Society sign from the Dollar Tree as well. I cannot get the words out. They still have these signs this year. It's a little bit different though, but I just attached it using some hot glue and I love the way that it looks. It kind of gives like a little fun frame to it. And then the little broom came from Hobby Lobby. This guy came from the Dollar Tree as well as the spider. This is actually the other spider that I used from those key holder plaques. I just added a little paint to the other one, but it's the same one. It comes in a pack of two. And then this guy actually was my husband's. I have no idea where he got this, but I love it and always incorporate it into my Halloween decor. And then carrying on to the kitchen shelves is more of the witch's layer stuff, if you will. And so a lot of this webbing, this top webbing actually is one of those Oriental Trading Company ones, and then these other smaller ones are from the Dollar Tree, and you can kind of see how you have to use your hands to make the holes in them, which is fine, but this stuff is really, really good and nice. But this little purple pumpkin is from the Dollar Tree. These little cardboard book boxes are from the Dollar Tree. And then of course the little rat is Dollar Tree. This was a DIY from this year using all Dollar Tree products, as well as this pumpkin. And I don't remember where this, you know what? That skull is from Dollar Tree as well. I think it was from last year, if I'm not mistaken. And then the poison glasses, these are like fun little kind of bourbon-ish glasses. It came in a pack of four or five. Oh, Gunnar has a ghost balloon, also from the Dollar Tree. Anyways, these came from Home Goods, and then I have just like the little Dollar Tree votive in there as well. And then over here, I made these years ago, and I just packed them up this way, and they have lasted for years. But I have just this little vase with some moss and these little plastic spider rings in there, and then this little jar filled with eyeballs. All of this stuff came from the Dollar Tree as well. And I just added some water and green food coloring to that one. And then again, another one of those cardboard boxes that looks like a book from the Dollar Tree, and then this little guy came from the Dollar Tree as well, and I think they have those again this year. They do have books again this year. I think that they're a little bit different though. And then I also have this little jar of mice. These came as a two-pack from the Dollar Spot, and then I don't remember where these came from. These are like really old jars that I had, and I actually had this leaked, and you can kind of see that it ran a little bit when it was being stored, but I kind of like how it looks like that. It makes it look a little more old and vintagey. I actually had purple poison in there, but I ran out of red food coloring, so I had to improvise and I made it a little kind of like teal color using blue and green, and I kind of like how it looks. And then I also have a jar filled with scorpions, and then again one of those little poison jars. This sign up here that says Trick or Treat also came from Home Goods. And then this is from Home Goods as well. I think it's super fun. Black of Night Cemetery Dirt. I just think that that's really cute and goes perfectly with this witch theme. And then of course this again is another Dollar Tree DIY using these little bitty skulls that you can get from there. And then all of these are Dollar Tree as well. And on the opposite wall, I just added a couple of things over here by our coffee station. I added this little Dollar Tree pumpkin, and then these little bat salt and pepper shakers. I'm trying to remember where I got these from. Maybe Hobby Lobby or Home Goods, one of those places. And then this thing I was on the hunt for all year this year. This Trick or Treat sign actually came from the Dollar Tree. I had been waiting for one of our stores to put it out, and they finally just did like a few weeks ago, and I had to have it. I like snatched it up as soon as I saw it. And the only other things that I did here in the kitchen was add this little bat nightlight. I think this came from Hobby Lobby. I've had this for years, but I think it is so cute. And he looks really cute here at night and in the morning when we first get up. And then I added another little Dollar Tree skull right here. And then another Dollar Tree pumpkin right by my flowers. When it comes to the different seasons and holidays, I do try to match my flowers to whatever that holiday or season is. So right now I'm really focusing on getting like orange colored flowers for fall and for Halloween. And these came from Trader Joe's. They're beautiful, they're $3.99 and they last for weeks. And then over here I have another Dollar Tree skull. And then I don't remember where these little glass holders came from, but again, that moss, and then these are Dollar Tree pumpkins. They actually come on picks and I just took them off the picks and put them in there. And if you caught my home tour from last year, then you remember these. This was a DIY from last year and I love these so much. These are also a favorite of mine. These are just printables that I found online, free Halloween printables, and then took just some regular plain Dollar Tree clipboards and attached them. And it's just a really easy, fun, simple way to add some Halloween into your decor. And then right here, I don't really have a lot going down this hall. It's kind of dark, but I have this beautiful sign hanging here. This is from Hobby Lobby. But I added this Hocus Pocus banner on top of it just to add a little something extra right there. I have these little wreaths on this door and then that other door over by those clipboards that are hanging there. But I just added these little bat clips to it. Those came from the Dollar Tree as well. The only other thing that I have here in the kitchen is this little pumpkin that Gunnar made last year. I'm trying to do something with each holiday, have him make something that I can put out with my decor for each holiday every single year. And so I just love this. I think it's so cute and it will just show the progression of his creativity from year to year. Right, buddy? Yeah. Oh, and then the other thing is this beware sign that's hanging above our kitchen sink. This is exactly like the happy haunting sign that I did in the living room on the fireplace. Unfortunately, I don't think you're gonna be able to see it, but it's the same exact thing. It just says beware. Moving into the dining room, I have these Dollar Tree skeleton chair covers over my chairs at our dining room table. And then I also have this.
They're actually mine.
They're not yours. Okay, this spider web placemat came from Hobby Lobby. And then this vase and these hydrangeas are typically what is sitting here on my table, but I just popped in a few of these Dollar Tree eyeball roses, which I think are so fun. And then over here on this little chair, I have this pillow came from Home Goods, and then this one came from the Target Dollar Spot like several years ago. And then I did a couple of different things here in the dining room. This is my candy bar that I did this year. It was something new. I have my little Dementor guy hanging from there. And then again, another one of those trick-or-treat signs, although I feel like I need to fix it because you can't quite see it under that spider web. But I love how this turned out. I thought it was so fun just to have all of the candy in one place. So I'm using this really pretty spider web table runner from Home Goods. And then this sign, the Crossbones Inn, came from Target, from the Dollar Spot, I believe last year, if I'm not mistaken. And then this guy is another dollar store DIY that I did this year, so I will link that below in case you wanna check that out. And then these are also from the Dollar Tree. I have two of them, and I just filled them with a little bit of moss. They're actually like fake tea light holders. They're battery operated, and you can just turn them on and they flicker. But I put some moss in there, and then I just put some suckers in there as well. And then I don't remember where the pumpkin came from, honestly. I feel like it maybe came from my grandma, if I'm not mistaken. And then again, another little rat, which is kind of hard to see. And then this and this also came from Home Goods. He is probably my absolute favorite DIY that I've ever done. Yes. I made it this year, so again, I will link to that below so you can check it out. This was actually inspired by... Right. This was actually inspired by something I saw for like $500 on the Grandin Road website, which they have amazing stuff, but it's kind of, is really expensive, not kind of. And so I recreated it using all dollar store items. Most everything came from the Dollar Tree, except for him. He came from a different store, but he was $5. So very affordable, not $500 like the other one is. And I love how he turned out. And then he is just holding one of these little champagne flutes, also from the Dollar Tree, and then these glow in the dark eyeballs from the Dollar Tree. And then this basket is again a Dollar Tree item, but you can get these everywhere, as well as this little guy. I've seen these all over the place, and I kind of always set him up like this. He's usually always swimming in this basket of candy because he loves candy so much. And then this vase is from Home Goods. I didn't really know what to do with it. I needed like something with height right here, and so I just plopped what I had left of these flowers from the Dollar Tree. This little area over here is my graveyard. I kind of did it different than last year. And so again, I'm just using this spider webbing from the Dollar Tree, and then these lanterns on both sides are also from the Dollar Tree. This was my husband's as well. I don't know where it came from, but I loved it and I use it every year in my Halloween decor. And then these are from the Dollar Tree as well. They're not supposed to look red like that. But if you guys remember, I told you that that poison jar leaked, and that's actually what happened to this. So anyways, and then these are just those little Dollar Tree votives that I put in there. And then of course these tombstones from the Dollar Tree. I love this one. It says Pearly Gates, which I shared this last year. My maiden name is Gates, so I kind of find this one to be a little humorous for me. And also we're Christians, so the Pearly Gates is just kind of a fun pun. I'm really big into like puns and sarcasm. So, and then this one is Buried Alive, which is funny too. And then let's see, these skulls are also from the Dollar Tree. This guy and this guy are from the Dollar Tree. And then these Trick or Treat and Enter If You Dare tombstones came from the Dollar Spot. And then the Boo is from Hobby Lobby. And then I have the counterpart to that other votive holder right there. And then up here is just an old antique window that I repurposed, and I used some of that Dollar Tree spider webbing on top of it. And then I have this DIY wreath that I made this year hanging from it. And then I felt like it needed, again, something, a little height right there. So I just put that Happy Halloween sign right there for now. I don't know if it's gonna stay there. Probably will at this point. I don't love it, but I don't hate it either. So we're just gonna go with it for now. So that is gonna be my Halloween home tour for this year. I really hope that you enjoyed it. I tried to not go crazy or overboard with the decorating, and I'm so happy with how everything turned out. I'm kind of glad that I did like little themes in the different areas, and I don't typically decorate our bathrooms or bedrooms. Maybe someday I will, but I kind of just keep it contained to the main areas of our house where we can enjoy it every single day and every evening. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that thumbs up button to let me know. I am not normally posting a lot of like Halloween or holiday, even DIY content for that matter. I'm normally sharing lots of food related videos, motherhood, lifestyle stuff, whether it be fashion, beauty, home decor, really just like things that I really love to watch. If you enjoy that type of content, be sure to hit that subscribe button. And if you recreate any of these DIYs that I've shared with you, definitely tag me on Instagram and let me know. I would love to see how they turned out for you. So thank you guys so much for watching and sharing in your time with me today. I hope that you have a great day and a happy Halloween. Bye.